So hello everyone. Today we have with us the lovely Mithila Palkar. She started off from a modest little video of herself singing, which went completely viral, and there has been no looking back for her ever since then. Hi Mithila, welcome to Midday.
Hi, thank you.
How has the lockdown been treating you? Just to as a starting question.
Lockdown's been okay. I mean, there are days and there are days. So there are days when I'm like all quirky and peppy and like, let's do this kind of a person. And then there are days where I just want to lay in bed and not do anything.
Good. You're just like us, because that's what we do. Except on most days, we don't like to get out of bed. So
no, I'm too restless, yeah, to stay in one place. So I'm just like, I need to keep doing some activity or the other to just stay active. I can't be like quiet and stable and sit at one place, which we are all having to do.
Mithila, it'll of course be a disservice not to talk about your legend of a co-star in Karwaan, which was Mr. Irfan Khan. He's pretty much changed the landscape of cinema in innumerable ways, I would say. I'm sure his passing came as quite a shock to you as well. It's been a few months now, so how are you coping with the loss?
It was unfathomable. We all obviously hoped and prayed that he'd get better. We all knew he was ailing, and it came as a complete shock that this has happened. That day, I think I was just too numb to even say anything. Usually, like, journalists call and they want you to say something or share a memory of him. And I have never been that inarticulate in my life. I was just like, मैं बात ही नहीं कर पा रही हूँ, मुझे पता ही नहीं क्या बोलना है, और ये कभी मेरे साथ नहीं हुआ है. तो I was just too numb to say anything. But I think he was fantastic. I think the next day for me was just, okay, I've taken this entire day in, and today I realize how an artist can impact people all across the globe. People right. were mourning him. All across the globe. People who had not even met him were feeling so low, and they felt like this was such a personal loss. And we have spent time with him on set, and he was such a jovial person, such a curious, like, he had that childlike curiosity in him. He used to always sit with me on sets, and he realized that I think he was soon going to shoot for a web series, and he knew that I work on the internet quite a bit. So he sat with me trying to understand how it works and kaun dekhta hai, phir tumhara audience kaun hota hai. And generally understanding social media. I used to sing a lot. I sing a lot. I keep singing anywhere. Any of my co-actors will complain. They'll not like say it out of pride or praise. They will be like, arey yaar, idhar take shuru hone ko hai aur ye gaate rehti hai kaan mein. ये हर मेरा को एक्टर ये कहेगा तुमसे. बट इरफान सर हैड नेम मी बिना का गीतमाला बिकॉज ऑफ दैट. जो अमीन से यानी का शो आया कर रहा था बिना का गीतमाला, सो ही यूज्ड टू कॉल मी दैट बिकॉज आई यूज्ड टू सिंग कीप सिंगिंग ओल्ड सॉन्ग. माय प्लेलिस्ट लाइक स्विचेस फ्रॉम 90s टू 70s टू 2000 टू लाइक ऑल ऑफ दैट. एंड लैंग्वेजेस आल्सो, लाइक आई सिंग रैंडम मराठी, हिंदी, इंग्लिश टाइप ऑफ थिंग्स. आई रिमेंबर हिम प्लेइंग क्रिकेट with everybody while setup was happening. The cricket bat was brought on set, and everybody, the crew members, were playing cricket. He has always like chilled, relaxed with us. He's never gone rushed back to his vanity van between takes, unless of course he had to. But right. otherwise, he's just been like, we've all. It was just a nice, happy family during the Karwaan shoot. Also, because we were not in Mumbai, I think that helped.
Yeah.
In a way, because Mumbai में होते तो shoot के बाद सब अपने-अपने घर चले जाते हैं. But Mumbai में थे नहीं तो घर जाना नहीं था, तो hotel में ही जाना था. So we used to all have our meals together and just sit and chill together. We've sung songs together just at like one end of the schedule dinner we had, because अभी सब pack करके सब Mumbai वापस जाने वाले थे. So we had done this big dinner and he had come there. There was, I remember we were shooting at the backwaters, and he kept seeing this boat, and he kept saying ke are wo mujhe wahan pe jana hai, I want to just row the boat just for the experience of it. Akar said okay. So once the thing was done, once our day wrapped, shoot was done, He said, "Ab to main jaunga." So he went, and then he was just randomly relaxing on the boat. I have a picture of him. I think I'll have to look for it. Yeah. So he was that like manchala kehte na, aur jo aise. He was very happy. He brought that like positive energy and vibe. He had that childlike curiosity of knowing and learning. And never did I feel like my first dialogue was to him. On my first day of shoot, and I was just like, how do I do this? Because it's Irfan Khan.
Yeah.
But my God, it was an experience, and it was such a blow. But I hope that he rests in peace.
Absolutely. And did you and Dulkar sort of like touch base and like just have like a little reminiscing sort of chat or anything of the sort?
Actually, Akash broke the news to me and said that sir is no more.
Akash is the director of your...
Akash Khurana is the director. But Akash wrote to me and I was like, oh my God, how did this happen? And I said, Akash, so it's not like we were best friends on set, right? Because at the end of the day, he was Irfan Khan. Like,
yeah.
I was not like bum chums with him. It was all of this was out of respect. We had a lot of fun, but in a very, in respectful boundaries. Yeah, I never really went beyond being like, kaise ho sir type of thing. It's him. You cannot like you couldn't. I just couldn't even imagine doing that with him. And I said, Akash, by that logic, we were not even so close to him. I wasn't. But it feels so personal, and I'm feeling so bad. And this is such a sinking feeling that I never thought that I'd have.
Yeah.
Because I don't know. Somewhere, I guess we all hope that he'd feel better.
Yeah.
And he throughout his. Ailing, he was so positive about it, and whoever met him during his treatment has always had like nice fun stories to tell us that, you know, he sat with me and chatted and whatever, he said this to me. So you would always hope for the better, right? If somebody's close to you, you would want to hope, you would obviously want that person to get better. So I said, Akash, I don't know, but this feels like too much of a personal loss. And then that entire day, everybody kept saying this, the same thing. Like, even if they were just his audience who had never seen him beyond his characters, I realized what a true art, what it takes to be a true artist. And this
you're
is
absolutely
how
right, actually. That was the one thing that even all of us, like across the board, anybody, even I talked to, like, it was like everyone said that, yeah, this feels personal. Like, this one is hitting way harder than anything else, you know. So yeah, definitely.
Yeah, it was just, and just that next morning I woke up and I was just like, my God, what was that man like?
Yeah.
It was just, he's absolutely impacted life and how, and I think that speaks a lot about him as an artist.
His legacy will stay for generations to come. Absolutely.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.